Hey everyone, Ava Bile here, and I hope you all had a good Thanksgiving. And today I'm going to be doing a review on McFarlane Toys DC Multiverse, and this is Rebirth the Joker. And he comes with his famous crowbar and then his long barrel revolver. And if we check the back of it out, or let's do the side, it just says the Joker. If you turn it, just says the Joker, and then on this side, the Joker DC Rebirth. If you check the back out, it just has a picture of him there, and on the bottom it shows a couple of the other guys in the line. Batman Earth -32, Batman Earth -1, Azrael, Batman Earth -44, and then the Grim Knight.
Turn that back around.
All right, so why don't we get Joker out of the package and take a closer look.
All right, here he is out of the package.
So as you can see, little accessories. He has the crowbar and the long barrel revolver. And with either of these, you can just pop them right into his hand. Now his hands, or his fingers, don't move that easily. So, it does get a little tough. Like, usually, fingers on figures can bend a little, give a little bit of leeway, just so you can fit stuff in them. But, not his. You got the crowbar, which doesn't... There we go. Now, the crowbar is loose in his hand, so you can slide up and down. Yeah, that didn't look too good. So we'll just take that out for now. All right, so Joker did come with one of those cards. So why don't we take a look at the card itself? That's just a great picture of Joker right there. And the back, of course, has some writing on it. All right, so the Joker, DC Rebirth, data file. Source, Justice League, number 8, Comics, 2018. Real name, unknown. Height, 6 feet 1 inch, or 1.85 meters. Weight, 160 pounds, or 72.57 kilograms. Once a small-time crook, the Joker fell into a vat of chemicals that turned his skin white, his hair green, and his lips red, like a crazed clown. His crimes always involve pranks and jokes ending with twisted punchlines that are only funny to the Joker. He may look like he's clowning around, but this guy is bad news for Batman and Gotham City. I always liked the Joker. He's one of my favorite villains for DC. I don't like where they went. If you've been paying attention, there's the three Joker storyline, which really makes no sense and it doesn't fit at all within the Wilmer Batman. If there really was three Jokers, you'd think Batman would have noticed at some point, since if you look at the comics, the faces are different on all three of them, and Batman's been face-to-face with Joker numerous times. He would have noticed that the face was different. They don't look the same at all. That's just a little rant. So, why don't we talk about the figure's color? He has his green hair, white skin. That's a nice looking white too. I like how they do that. They did that with a lot of the Joker figures. This really like white paint for the face. And he has his crimson red smile. Now, another thing I don't like is what they did to his around his eyes. I don't know why they put red around. That to me just doesn't really match. It should have been black. I'm sure he might have had red around his eyes. Maybe. But I can't remember it. I'm pretty sure it was always black. And then he has his discolored brownish teeth. And if we keep looking, he's got his purple suit with the green vest underneath. And then a yellow shirt underneath that. Green tie, yellow flower. He's got his white gloves, and he's got a metallic chain for, I would assume, a pocket watch, and black shoes. So this is a really good looking figure, a lot of details on it. His pinstripe suit actually has pinstripes. It is actually on the collar part of the suit, two different purples. So let's talk about movability. Oh, we'll start up at his head. You can actually rotate it all the way around. Can't really look up too well. So this is the extent of him looking up, which is non-existent. Looking down, at least he can get a little bit. He's got his arms, they can rotate all the way. Yeah, 90 degree raise. And you can also twist right at the bicep area. He's got double jointed elbows. You can get a lot of good bend on that. Which makes sense, because Joker is a wiry dude. And then he got his hands. These can also turn. And they got a little bit of flip-flappy action. Alright, so we can start moving down more. He's got his waist, which... the waist I'd be careful with. When you twist it, it can actually come right off. It's just a little... kind of like a ball in there. And something that just clamps onto it. So it's best if you, I mean, you could twist it around, but he's just going to pop right back off again. He's not made for that. But it's not breaking it. It just, like I said, it pops off. You can pop it right back. But it's good for tilting him. Nope. Pop back off again. Jeez. Oh. They can get a pretty good angle going. Alright, his legs can do a full 180. You can raise it. He's got 90. Going back. Oh, keeps wanting to pop off his waist. Not bad for going back. More than some figures have. He's got double jointed knees. Look at that. Really good on that. Getting them parallel to each other. And you got the feet. Rotate all around. Also, flip-flap up and down. Not much. There's a little bit there. And then you got the toes. He'd want to pop off the waist. There we go. That's better. He's on there now. And, of course, they like to come with a little basic stand. Just says DC. Alright, so, I mean, it's a really good figure. The only real problems I have, like I said, I don't care for the red around the eyes. I think they really shouldn't have done that. They should have went with just black. That's what people are used to. That's how he is in the comics. Like, even the card that it comes with, he actually doesn't have any red around his eyes. So, I don't know why they decided to do that here. And I do like how he has a couple strands of hair in the front. Just kind of coming out like that. Good detail. They're good with the details. I don't know if you can see in there, but he has like a really dark red tongue. I mean, the waist is kind of a problem. I mean, not really. Like, it does the job it's supposed to. You can turn it a little bit. Oh, there it goes again. It's not broken. It's just the way it stays on. And, you know, you got... I mean, another thing I would have liked is if they actually had separate pieces, at least for the vest to the jacket. But it's all one... this whole part of his jacket is just one piece, kind of a flexible kind of material, flexible plastic. Same with his little coattails here. Because a lot of figures you come across, at least I find, when you put weapons in their hands, like they'll go in, but they're a little loose, where they'll slide around, kind of like how you saw the Crowbar did it. The Crowbar would go up and down in his hand, no problem. He can't really hold it that tight. But with the pistol, see, you can shake it around. It's not loose. I can move it. Nope, just moves the whole arm with it. Well, I hope you all liked my review on McFarlane Toys DC Rebirth The Joker. And as always, you know, any comments, feel free to leave them down below. And like, subscribe, and I'll see you all later.